Hello and welcome to edupediaworld.com. In the last session, we have discussed about that how consumer reaches his equilibrium point, that is the level of maximum satisfaction, when the consumer consumes only one commodity. But in practice, this is not true. That is, a consumer does not spend his limited money income only on one commodity. He consumes n number of commodities. For example, I may not be only consuming cereals. I am consuming vegetables, I am consuming bread, I am consuming flour, I am consuming various other things. That is, I am spending my limited money income on various number of goods and services. Thus, it is very important to understand that how a consumer reaches his equilibrium when he consumes various commodities, that is n number of commodities. Thus, in this session, we'll be studying about how consumer reaches his equilibrium when he consumes multiple number of commodities. Now, in order to start, let's just revise two assumptions under cardinal utility approach. That is, a consumer has limited money income. Consumer has limited money income to spend on the goods or services he or she consumes. And the other assumption is that it has been assumed that utility gained from the successive units of a commodity decreases as a person consumes them, meaning that various commodity is subject to diminishing marginal returns. Now, as we also know that the various marginal utility schedules of various commodities may not be the same. That is, I may be having more satisfaction from the consumption of one commodity as compared to other. MU decreases more rapidly than in case of others for the same number of units consumed. I may be consuming 10 units of apple and 10 units of orange, but the marginal utility derived from apple may be more than the marginal utility derived from the consumption of oranges. Thus, a utility maximizing consumer picks up that commodity first which maximizes his utility more. He switches his expenditure from one commodity to the other in accordance with their marginal utilities. He continues to switch his expenditure from one commodity to other till he reaches a stage where marginal utility of each commodity is the same per unit of expenditure. This is called the law of equi-marginal utility, which we have already studied in the session under the topic some fundamental concepts. Let's just revise that. Suppose, for example, I have a limited money income of $100 and I have to spend this limited money income on three commodities, namely bread, vegetables, and cereals. Suppose a unit to be spent on this commodity, on any three commodity, requires $10 each. So I can buy 10 units combining these three commodities. Now let's see that how I will be allocating my money income so that I get the maximum satisfaction from the consumption of these three commodities. Suppose the marginal utility schedule of these three commodities is given. $70, $68, $63, $62, and $59. From vegetables, the marginal utility derived is 67, 65, 62, 60 and 58. From cereals, the marginal utility is 66, 63, 62, 61 and 60. Thus, starting as a utility maximizing consumer, I'll spend my first unit on the product which will give me the maximum marginal utility. So I'll allocate my first unit on bread. Then again I will allocate my second unit on bread because this is giving me the maximum marginal utility. The third unit I'll be allocating on vegetables. Then fourth unit I'll be allocating on cereals. Then fifth unit I will be allocating again on vegetables. Sixth unit I will be allocating on cereals. Then seventh unit I will be allocating on bread. Eighth unit I will be allocating on vegetables. Ninth unit I will be allocating on cereals. And tenth unit I will be allocating on bread. So ultimately we can conclude here that I was going on with the allocation of the limited money income on these three commodities until the marginal utility derived from per unit expenditure on these three commodities became same. Now this particular allocation will be giving me maximum marginal utility. So this is the point where I will be reaching my equilibrium. That is the point of maximum satisfaction. As we have already done the law of equi-marginal utility, the law of equi-marginal utility explains the consumer's equilibrium in a multi-commodity model. The law states that a consumer consumes various goods in such quantities that the marginal utility derived per unit of expenditure from each good is the same. In other words, a rational consumer spends his income on various goods he consumes in such a manner that each rupee spent on each good yields the same MU. See? We were allocating the money income on these three goods until we get the same MU, 62. So this is the point of maximum satisfaction for me. Now, in order to explain the law in a better way, I would take an example of a consumer who consumes only two commodities. Suppose he consumes only two commodities, that is X and Y. Now their prices being for commodity X, the price is PX, and for commodity Y, the price is PY. Following the equilibrium rule under one commodity model, a consumer will reach his equilibrium point when the marginal utility derived from X is equals to price of X into marginal utility of money. Same ways, marginal utility derived from Y will be equal to price of Y into marginal utility of money. Given these conditions, if the consumer is consuming two commodities, then we can equate them by marginal utility of X divided by price of X into marginal utility of money. As marginal utility of money is constant, so we can equate them is equals to 1, which will be equal to marginal utility of Y upon price of y into marginal utility of money. Thus, we can say that because these two equations, that is marginal utility of x per unit of expenditure on it is equal to marginal utility of y per unit of expenditure. So we can equate these two equations by saying that marginal utility of x upon px is equals to marginal utility of y upon py. We have removed marginal utility of money from this equation because marginal utility of money is always constant, which is equal to 1. So px into 1 will be px and py into 1 will be py. And because both these equations is equals to 1, so we have equated them. Thus, it leads to the conclusion that the consumer reaches his equilibrium when the marginal utility derived from each unit of rupees spent on the two commodities X and Y is the same. Thus, this two commodity model, that is, a consumer reaches his equilibrium when the marginal utility of each unit is spent on these commodities is the same. This two commodity model can be generalized for a large number of commodities where the consumer consumes a large number of commodities. Thus, we can clearly say that if the consumer is consuming large number of commodities, then the per unit expenditure on all these commodities, the consumer will allocate his money income in such a way that the per unit expenditure on all these commodities and the marginal utility derived becomes the same. Thus, in a multi-commodity model, a consumer reaches his equilibrium, that is the point of maximum satisfaction, according to the law of equi-marginal utility, which says that a consumer consumes various goods in such quantities that the marginal utility derived from each good is the same. Thank you.